put God first. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. The best makeup artist. Candy 2 4 2 3 9 5 0 1 2 5.
You don't even know how very special you are.
Commitment and consistency. In its simplest terms, it book a demo. Back. Product show submenu for product. Pricing. Integrations show submenu for integrations. Customers. Learn show submenu for learn. Sign in. Get closer to your customers with Drip. Try Drip free. Start of main content. Blog. Crow. Use these commitment and consistency examples to catapult your e-commerce brand. May 24, 2022, 8 minutes read. Commitment and consistency is one of Robert Cialdini's 6 principles of persuasion, which influences buying decisions. In its simplest terms, it describes the way in which people want their beliefs and behaviors to be consistent with their values and self-image. Cialdini explains that one of the main ways we judge one another, as well as ourselves, is through our actions. Consistency is usually viewed as a desirable social trait and shows that we're logical, stable, and trustworthy. So, once we've made a choice and committed to something, there's a natural compulsion to behave consistently with that commitment. And this can have massive implications within the context of e-commerce marketing. If you can get a shopper to commit to a choice, even if it's relatively insignificant, it can often lead to them making bigger commitments in the future, while encountering less resistance. It's all about getting your foot in the door and encouraging the shopper to make a small choice, which sets the stage for them to make a large choice later on. Now, let me take a deep dive into this topic and provide you with several commitment and consistency examples so you can gain a better understanding of how e-commerce brands are using this powerful psychological principle. And more importantly, you can use the takeaways to guide your own strategies and elevate your brand. The way in which people want their beliefs and behaviors to be consistent with their values and self-image. Cialdini explains that one of the main ways we judge one another, as well as ourselves, is through our actions. Consistency is usually viewed as a desirable social trait and shows that we're logical, stable, and trustworthy. So, once we've made a choice and committed to something, there's a natural compulsion to behave consistently with that commitment. And this can have massive implications within the context of e-commerce marketing. If you can get a shopper to commit to a choice, even if it's relatively insignificant, it can often lead to them making bigger commitments in the future, while encountering less resistance. It's all about getting your foot in the door and encouraging the shopper to make a small choice, which sets the stage for them to make a large choice later on. Now, let me take a deep dive into this topic and provide you with several commitment and consistency examples so you can gain a better understanding of how e-commerce brands are using this powerful psychological principle. And more importantly, you can use the takeaways to guide your own strategies and elevate your brand.
Without commitment, you'll never start. But more importantly, without consistency, you'll never finish. Keep working, keep striving, never give up, fall down 7 times, get up 8. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. So keep moving, keep growing, keep learning. See you at work.
Problem is that when we organize to win, that means the score is more important than the inspiration or motivation than people have to give their blood, sweat, and tears. What gets measured gets done. These things are measurable, just not in the short term. Do you love your wife?
Yes.
Right? Prove it. Like, what's the metric? Give me the number that helps me know, right? Because when you met her, you didn't love her, right?
True.
Now you love her, right? Tell me the day the love happened. It's an impossible question, right? But it's not that it doesn't exist. It's that it's much easier to prove over time, right? So all leadership is the same thing. It's about transition, right? It's like exercise, right? If you go to the gym and you work out and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. And if you go to the gym the next day and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing, right? So clearly there's no results, can't be measured, it must not be effective. So we quit, right? Or if you fundamentally believe that this is the right course of action and you stick with it, like in a relationship, I bought her flowers and I wished her happy birthday, and she doesn't love me. Clearly I'll give up, you know? That's not what happens. If you believe there's something there, you commit yourself to an act of service. You commit yourself to the regime, the exercise. You can screw it up. You can eat chocolate cake one day. You can skip a day or two. You know, it allows for that. But if you stick with it consistently, I'm not exactly sure what day, but I know you'll start getting into shape. I know it. And the same with the relationship. It's not about the events. It's not about intensity. It's about consistency, right? You go to the dentist twice a year, your teeth will fall out. You have to brush your teeth every day for 2 minutes. What does brushing your teeth twice a day for 2 minutes do? Nothing. Unless you do it every day, twice a day for 2 minutes. Right? It's the consistency. Going to the gym for 9 hours does not get you into shape. Working out every day for 20 minutes gets you into shape. So the problem is we treat leadership with intensity. We have a 2-day offsite, we invite a bunch of speakers, we give everybody a certificate, you're a leader, right? It's the daily practice of all the monotonous, little, boring things like brushing your teeth that matter the most. She didn't fall in love with you because you remembered her birthday and bought her flowers on Valentine's Day. She fell in love with you because when you woke up in the morning, you said good morning to her before you checked your phone. She fell in love with you because when you went to the fridge to get yourself a drink, you got her one without even asking. She fell in love with you because when you had an amazing day at work and she came home and she had a terrible day at work, you didn't say, yeah, but let me tell you about my day. You sat and listened to her awful day and you didn't say a thing about your amazing day. This is why she fell in love with you. I can't tell you exactly what day, and it was no particular thing you did. It was the accumulation of all of those little things that she woke up one day and as if she pressed a button, she goes,
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he starts a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it is explained today that I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that We are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that because it's true. Before you even says, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Mr. Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or a zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, so that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold him back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bongan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rado, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rado. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rado. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. You in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching.